A countywide ban on campfires and backyard fire pits is on the way. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News. First, Summit Schools is revisiting its restart plan. The school board holds a meeting tonight to review the district's blended learning model. They've had concerns from parents worried that in-person learning is dangerous for health and virtual learning is dangerously inadequate because it is based on a third-party platform. The board could also delay restart by another week or more, pushing class into September. This comes as 13% of all students, roughly 467 kids, are brand new to the district this year. That meeting is tonight, 5 o'clock on Zoom. Two large fires continue burning west of Summit, one on 4,600 acres in Glenwood Canyon, another on 59,000 acres north of Grand Junction. By tomorrow, open fires of any kind in Summit could be banned. Summit Sheriff Jamie Fitzsimons on the Krystal Morning Show today.
All local, state, federal partners have decided to go into a stage 2 fire restriction because of what's going on. And so this afternoon, I'll be recommending that to our Board of County Commissioners.
The White River National Forest and BLM land enter Stage 2 tomorrow, and Fitzsimons expects all I-70 counties between Summit and Utah to adopt Stage 2. Stage 2 means no campfires, even at campgrounds, and no backyard fires, even with a permit. Believe it or not, June sales tax revenue is up across the board for every local town, except Breckenridge. Silverthorne was up 2.5% compared to last year, Frisco up nearly 8%. Even Summit County collections rose 2% higher than 2019, while Breckenridge revenue was down 19%. A strong June is slowly erasing big losses from shutdown. The county is behind last year by just 4.5%, Frisco and Silverthorne down 8%, while Breck taxes trail last year by nearly 22%. Summer is booming at local bike and outdoor shops.
Anybody that couldn't get a new bike or didn't want to get a new bike is trying to fix their old bike up. And so pretty much, you know, every size tube now is almost out of stock. Parts, tools, you know, everything related to bikes.
That was Lucy Hedrick with Wilderness Sports in Dillon. They've been selling out of bike parts for weeks, and she is hoping this momentum rolls right into winter.
We're kind of unique that we're a backcountry shop, so whether the resort's open or not, I think we're going to be pretty slammed this winter, so we're kind of gearing up, increasing our orders, and we're ready to hit the ground rolling.
Is Hedrick worried about winter shortages? Not yet. Wilderness just ordered a whole bunch of backcountry gear this week, ready for retail by October. The latest now on coronavirus and that useless neck gaiter you've been wearing is a face mask. A recent study by Duke University looked at a dozen face mask models, finding that most protect against virus spread, except for single-layer buff-style spandex gaiters. Yep, the one thing everyone in ski country already owns does not prevent droplets from escaping and might even make things worse by turning large droplets into smaller ones. N95s, surgical masks, and double-layer cloth are the best. Summit County's resident caseload per 100,000 today is 50.0, up 5 points from yesterday, with a positive test rate of 2.4%, down about 1 point. Summit Medical Center is at 12% capacity, about 4 patients total, still with no COVID admissions since July 26th. The Breckenridge Oktoberfest street party is out, and Breck-FEAST is in. Breck-FEAST is the town's COVID-conscious replacement for Oktoberfest, featuring three-course meals at local restaurants paired with Polliner beer. It is a nod to the popular Brewmaster's dinners and runs for 2 weekends starting September 25th. Blue River Bistro, Relish, and more are involved. In sports, the Rockies lost to the Diamondbacks yesterday 13-7, giving up 8 runs in the eighth. The Avalanche beat the Coyotes 3-0, and the Nuggets lost to the Clippers 124-111. All Colorado teams are off today. And in local sports, brought to you by American Family Insurance, the WEIS agency, race 4 of the virtual mountain bike town series went down yesterday on the Soda Creek Scramble Course, where Taylor Sheldon remained undefeated, claiming his 4th overall and men's title of the season. Christina Ward won the women's race. Finn Ramis took the Enduro crown. Next race in that virtual series is the Peaks Trail Time Trial, August 25th to 26th. Yesterday was also the Camp Hale Hup near Red Cliff, part of the Vail Rec District mountain bike series, where Josiah Madaw won the men's and overall race, and Summit's own Lassie Konechny took third. His brother Nico won the men's sport division. Michaela Thompson, out of Boulder, won the women's pro title. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News.